some of you may know, Dad was fascinated with bears, which whilst they can look kindly, there's a, not everyone goes seeking them out like him and I did each time we went to Canada. We said to see more bears than the natives did. We even went to the Northern Arctic on two occasions to see the polar bears, which is an amazing experience. It's true that we did have a few near do's, and Dad clearly recalled the one with the young polar bear who really had us for his lunch. On one of these trips to the Northern Arctic, after returning from the tundra, a guy said he wanted to take Dad and I alone to Cape Churchill, which was a pretty desolate location, let alone it being minus 36. Once there, a bottle of rum was produced by the guide and some glasses. No idea where he got this from. He filled the glasses and he said, "We're going to splice the main brace and toast it to a Nelson." 21st of October 1994 was Trafalgar Day, and the guide had noticed Dad's name and time, which he always wore without fail on that day. On the subject of history, Nelson, and as Tracy touched upon, Dad was extremely interested in historical matters and absorbed himself fully. He would read each night in bed, smoking his Dunhill pipe and having a dram of whiskey or rum. It helped him unwind. On the subject of history, I think it's important, Father would like me to say, that he never forgot how his father had endured 3.5 years of treachery there in World War I and was left dying one autumn afternoon. He was saved by a German deserter who carried him to the Red Cross lines. Dad was always sorry that we never got to know the identity of a German soldier, as neither he, Tracy, or I would be here today without that. Dad was eternally grateful for all who safeguarded freedom, and his admiration for the armed forces and his love of military music was imprinted in Tracy and I from a very young age. I'm just going to conclude with regards to two wheels, and as you know, Tracy's touched on before the war, Dad was an ardent cyclist and he cycled from Lancashire to Devon without a second thought. However, this love of two wheels wasn't considered a limited to bicycles. He progressed to motorcycles, as Tracy mentioned. Dad went to County School, Mallardville as well, with Jeff Duke. Jeff became 6 times world motorcycle world champion, and they enjoyed meeting up again for the last time in 2000. And Jeff actually asked Dad, when he moved to Falls, to be his navigator in the Monte San Carlo Rally, but sadly Dad couldn't get the time. When Dad did retire, which I think he'd like me to trace, it wasn't in 1985, 86, it was in 91, because he wouldn't give up, because he was unstoppable. He did Land's End to John O'Groats for charity on his BMW bike. He did it under 17 hours. Now, for a lot of people, that would be quite an achievement, but actually, it's not truly representative of how Dad's endurance character prevailed. He managed to talk me into doing some 24-hour motorcycle competitions, him riding his bike and myself, and he'd done these in the 50s, and rather foolishly I agreed to this. Well, you've never seen anything like it. He would go like the papers, and even after 20 hours, you're thinking, well, is there no stopping, there's no tiring. It's true he consumed quite a lot of Red Bull and his energy drinks, so when we did finish he didn't sleep for a long time, but he achieved 9 top 10 finishes with the last world at age 79, 2008. I could never get over his stamina, or indeed one humorous matter occurred on the way back from Doncaster once, where I managed to lose him on the way home. I was a bit concerned because we were totally shattered. And nowhere to be found. And then he had a fluorescent jacket on. I saw his bike in the distance and a white minibus. And he was surrounded by loads of people shaking his hand and patting him on the back. I turned up and asked him what was going on. He said he hadn't got a clue. But unfortunately, these people thought he was the AA rescue man. He enjoyed all those times so much, and he said that he'd never imagined one day he'd be motorcycling with his son. Dan, I will never forget those days. They were absolutely natural, whatever they said. Anyway, I'm sorry, I've whizzed on quite a lot. I'd like to conclude by again saying a big thank you. Dan was truly grateful to be never in a home. He's sitting up and transporting out of hospital. He still had his own team. I would like to thank Mandy, Robert, Danny, Sylvia in particular. Thank you all so much for enabling Dad to carry on his last spell as he wanted it. He loved all his family. I know he'd been especially missed by Harry and all that looks. He wouldn't want us to be unhappy. The last few years were extremely tough, but he never gave up. His tenacity and perseverance personified him. If Tracy and I, and his grandchildren, can inherit any of his attributes, I think we would be extremely fortunate. I doubt we can. Finally, on his humour, I will leave you with this. On the 31st of May 1991, we were at Liverpool Airport waiting for a flight to the Isle of Man TT, and that disappeared for quite a lengthy time. I wonder where he'd gone. After searching all over the place in this turtle room, I found him standing upstairs, grinning like a Cheshire cat. He was on the end of a rugby tour photograph. And he said, well, I used to do this sort of thing at school. He never grew up. So Dad, we'll raise a glass to you later, and as he always said to us, God bless and take care, and I think he wished us to say that to you all. Thank you.
So we come to our next hymn, which traces the story of our human life and offers words of comfort and reassurance. Lord of all hopefulness,
Thank you.
light. We thank you for the life of Derek, for the love and mercy he received from you and showed among us. Above all, we rejoice at your gracious promise to all your servants, living and departed, that we shall rise again at the coming of Christ. And we ask that in due time we may share with him that clearer vision when we shall see your face in the same Christ our Lord. Amen. And we pray for those of you who have been closest to him. Father in heaven, you gave your Son Jesus Christ to suffering and to death on the cross and raised him to life in glory. Grant us a patient faith in time of darkness and strengthen our hearts with the knowledge of your love through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And a prayer for ourselves, that we may leave this beautiful church with peace in our hearts. O Lord, support us all the day long of this pilgrim life until the shades lengthen and the evening comes, the busy world is hushed, the fever of life is over and our work done. Then, Lord, in your mercy, grant us safe lodging, a holy rest, and peace at the last, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
We say together a prayer that our Lord Jesus Christ taught us to say. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever. Final hymn, guide me, O thou great Redeemer.
you. You gave your love to us. God give his deep love to you. You gave your time to us. God give his eternity to you. You gave your light to us. God give everlasting light to you. Go upon your journey, dear soul, to love, light, and life eternal. Amen. And so may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen.